Good morning, children. How are you all? Yes, you all are very fine at home. Yes, no? So, in the previous period, we have completed the lesson number 3, right? What was the lesson number 3 about? Who will tell me? Have we completed the notes? Yes, children. So, lesson number 3 was about the location of our country on the world map. Isn't it? Yes. So, now today onwards, we are going to see deep about our country. Deep information about our country. Okay. So, today we are going to start with the fourth number lesson, that is the Northern Mountains and the Northern Plains. Right? It means the north side of India, it is covered by mountains and plains. So, we are going to see about that. How the people they are living over there. What are the mountains in this northern side. Everything we will see there. Okay? Yes, children. So, before that, in your textbook, page number 21, you have to solve this on your mark activity. What is given there? See, have you ever been to a hill station? Write yes or no for the questions given below. So children, if you have visited any hill station, so read these following questions. If it is yes, put the tick mark. If it is no, put the cross mark. Right? See, did you see mountains and valleys? Did the mountain roads give you a roller coaster ride? Did you see snow-capped peaks? Snow-capped means it, highest peak or which are covered by the snow. So, it is called snow-capped peaks. Where the were the trees over the very tall, over there very tall and erect. Erect means very straight, just like backbone. Then, did you notice how elevation of the land increased gradually as you moved closer to your destination? So, these are the questions in your on your mark activity. So, if you have visited, if you have seen, you will put the tick mark. If it is no, then you will put, you will write no over there. Understood about this activity? Yes. So, now we will continue with the lesson. Yes. See here, children. So, the first part of our lesson is Northern Mountains. Okay, now here on the screen, you can see this map, right? The part or the area from the map which is covered by brown color, this all part is known as Northern Mountains. Okay, first we'll see about that. Mountains are areas of land that have risen high above the surrounding areas. Isn't it? Mountains means what actually, children? Mountains is also part of a land, but which has risen above the surrounding land. So, temperature falls with increase in height. Therefore, mountainous regions have a cool climate. Children, it is the rule of the nature, as we go up high, the temperature decreases. Temperature falls down. So, therefore, because of this rule, the climate in the mountain ranges is very cold. In case of very high mountains, peaks remain covered with the snow around the year. Yes, children. So, those where are the mountains which are very high, at the highest peak, there most of the year the peak, these peaks are covered by the ice, full year, snow. Okay. Children, the northern boundary of the country is covered by mountains. You can see here in the map also, hai na? This is the northern boundary. Just wait. See here. This is the northern boundary, right? Which is covered by the mountains. They are known as the northern mountains. They include the Himalayas, Karakoram and some hill ranges in the northeast. Children, these are the northern mountains, but what are the mountain ranges included in this northern mountains? They are the main Himalayas mountain range, then the Karakoram mountain range and some hill ranges in the northeast. You can see here exact on the map, just a minute. See here. Just zoom it and see it properly. See, there are different mountain ranges in the northern mountain, but the main mountain ranges are Himalayan mountain ranges, Karakoram and some hill ranges in the northeast. Got it? So this was about the northern mountains. Now children, we are going to see the detailed information about the main mountain range from the north side, that is Himalayas, Himalayan mountains. Children, now Himalayas is a majestic mountain range. It is the highest and one of the longest mountain ranges in the world. You can see here. The mountain range covering north and northeastern part of our country is called the Himalayas. See here, it is indicated. North side also and northeastern part. Then the Himalaya is the highest mountain range in the world. Understood, children? So Himalayas is the highest mountain range in the world. Yes. So it extends from about 2400 km from east to west, and its width varies from 400 km in Kashmir to 150 km in the northeast in India. Now children, Kashmir is exact at the north side. So from Kashmir to the northeast of the India, its width varies from 400 km up to 150 km. In India, it stretches in a curve from Jammu and Kashmir in the west to Arunachal Pradesh and east. Jammu and Kashmir in the west to Arunachal Pradesh in the east, thus spreading India, separating India and China through a natural boundary. Understood, children? See here, you can see in this map, here is the China. Here is the China, right? Now see, in India, it stretches in a curve from Jammu Kashmir in the west. See, here is the Jammu Kashmir. And it stretches from this in the west to the Arunachal Pradesh in the east, like this. And thus, because of this, the India and China both separated by this natural boundary. So here is the India and here is the China. It is separated because of this natural boundary of Himalayan mountains. Understood? You can see in the map booklet also, which is backside of your book. There you can see in the Himalayan mountain range map is there. So there you can see how it is separated. Okay, children. So till here everyone understood? Yes. Now children, we are going to see some highest peaks in the world are in the Himalayas. As we know that Himalayan mountain ranges are the highest mountain range in the world. So there are the highest peaks. So what are they? Just we'll see in your textbook, page number 22, the chart is given. Name of the peak, altitude and location. Altitude means height of that peak and then its location. See here, the first highest peak is the Mount Everest. What is the name of the highest peak? Mount Everest. What is the height of this? 8,848 meter. And where it is? It is in the Nepal. Second is K2 mountain range, K2 peak. What is the height? 8,611 meters. And its location is in Pakistan. Then Kanchenjunga, 8,586 meter. And the location is in India. Okay, so these three are the highest peaks in the world are in the Himalayas. Okay, Everest, K2 and Kanchenjunga. These three are the highest peak in the world and these three peaks lies in Himalayas. Understood till here everyone? Yes. Now children, Himalayan mountain range is a such a huge and big mountain range. Right. So, for the part of this study, the Himalayas are divided into three parallel ranges. It is the biggest mountain range in the world, isn't it? So, for that, the Himalayas are divided into three parallel ranges. You can see here in this picture. Himalayan system. Okay, see here. So the first one is the Greater Himalayas, which is also called as Himadri, has an average height of 6,000 meter and is the highest range in the Himalayas. See, here you can see the Greater Himalayas, okay, which is highest, maximum height is 6,000 meter. Then the second one is the Middle Himalayas or the Lesser Himalayas, which is also known as Himachal. Here you can see Lesser Himalayas or Middle Himalayas, which is also known as Himachal, lies to the south of the Himadri and has average height of 3,700 to 4,500. See, here you can see Lesser Himalayas. Okay, and then the next is Outer Himalayas or the southernmost range of the Himalayas are also known as the Shivalik. See here, this is the Outer Himalayas and this is the Shivalik also. Both are the same, also known as Shivalik mountain range. The average height here is from 900 to 1200 meter. Okay, so these are the three parallel Himalayan mountain ranges. Have you understood? Yes, children. So, according to the height of the mountain ranges, the Himalayan mountain is divided into three mountain ranges. That is Greater Himalayas, which is known as Himadri, Lesser Himalayas, then third one is the Outer Himalayas, or we can call it as a Shivalik also. So, till here everyone understood? Yes. Yes, children. Now, we are going to see some brief information about these three parallel ranges. So, which one is the first one? Which is Greater Himalayas. Isn't it? What is the another name for it? It is also known as Himadri. Okay? So, let's see about it. This is the Greater Himalayas. See here, you can see the picture also. Almost all the mountain is covered by the snow. You can see here, right? Now, we'll see. The Greater Himalayas or Himadri is the northernmost and highest range of the Himalayas. The peaks are permanently covered with the snow. I told you just now, see, it is in the picture. The peaks are almost covered with the snow throughout the year. Mount Everest, the highest peak in the world, lies in this range in Nepal. What is the location of the Mount Everest, children? इट इज़ इन द नेपाल. कांचनजंगा, नंदा देवी एंड नंगा पर्वत आर द हाइएस्ट पीक्स ऑफ द ग्रेटर हिमालयाज इन इंडिया. नाउ चिल्ड्रन, माउंट एवरेस्ट, K2 एंड कांचनजंगा, दीज आर द थ्री हाइएस्ट माउंटेन पीक्स इन द वर्ल्ड विच लाइज इन हिमालयाज. नाउ फ्रॉम द ग्रेटर हिमालयाज, कांचनजंगा, सॉरी माउंट एवरेस्ट इन नेपाल विच इज़ द हाइएस्ट इन द वर्ल्ड, देन कांचनजंगा, नंदा देवी एंड नंगा पर्वत, दीज थ्री हाइएस्ट पीक्स ऑफ द ग्रेटर हिमालयाज विच आर इन इंडिया. द टेम्परेचर रिमेन्स वेरी लो थ्रू आउट द ईयर एंड कल्टिवेशन इज नॉट पॉसिबल एट सच अ हाइट, दस दिस एरिया इज नॉट फिट फॉर ह्यूमन सेटलमेंट. एज वी नो चिल्ड्रन, जस्ट लाइक इट इज फुल एरिया इज कवर्ड बाय द स्नो ओनली थ्रू आउट द ईयर, सो हाउ इट विल बी पॉसिबल टू लिव इन सच एरिया, देर इज टेम्परेचर इज ऑलवेज लो, वी कांट डू एनी कल्टिवेशन और क्रॉप, नथिंग इज देर, सो इट इज नॉट सुटेबल फॉर द ह्यूमन सेटलमेंट. ओके, हियर विल सी वॉट इज गिवन, यू नो वॉट. द सियाचिन ग्लेशियर इज लोकेटेड इन द काराकोरम रीजन एंड इज द हाइएस्ट बैटल फील्ड ऑन अर्थ, स्टैंडिंग एट एन अल्टीट्यूड ऑफ ओवर 5,400 मीटर. सोल्जर्स ऑफ बोथ द इंडियन एंड पाकिस्तानी आर्मीज गार्ड देयर बॉर्डर्स हियर. सी चिल्ड्रन, इन सच अ हाई माउंटेन रेंजेस, हाउ द आर्मी दे आर प्रोटेक्टिंग अवर कंट्री विच आर ऑन द हाइएस्ट माउंटेन रेंजेस. सियाचिन ग्लेशियर विच इज लोकेटेड इन द काराकोरम रीजन. वॉट इज द हाइट ऑफ इट चिल्ड्रन? द हाइट इज ओवर द 5,400 मीटर एंड सोल्जर्स ऑफ बोथ इंडिया ऑल्सो एंड पाकिस्तान आर्मीज ऑल्सो दे गार्ड अवर कंट्री फ्रॉम दिस बॉर्डर. जस्ट इमेजिन हाउ दे आर डूइंग देयर ड्यूटीज एंड जॉब. यस, सो दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट द ग्रेटर हिमालयाज. Now the next is the middle or lesser Himalayas, which is the below of greater Himalayas. This range lies between the Himadri and Shivalik range. See children, now Himadri and Shivalik range. Okay, Himadri means the greater Himalayas and Shivalik means the lower Himalayas, or we can call it as the outer Himalayas also. So this middle or lesser Himalayas lies between Himadri and Shivalik. The mountains here are not as high and the temperatures are not as low as in the Himadri range. Naturally, children, the height decreases, isn't it? So that is why the temperature also increases. Yes. Now we will see here. Now children, in this region, Rohtang Pass is a high mountain pass in this range that connects the Kulu Valley with the Lahul and Spiti Valley of Himachal Pradesh. Yes children, Kulu, Manali, Simla, these are the hill stations, famous hill station from the Himachal Pradesh. So if anyone can see this, then there is this Rohtang Pass. We can see Rohtang Pass in the Himachal Pradesh also, which connects this valley. Which are the valleys? Kulu Valley with the Lahul and Spiti Valley of Himachal Pradesh. This range has cold winters and mild summers. Yes children, because here also some part is covered with the snow. That is why the winter is cold and summer is not that much high at the temperature. It is mild summer. The mountain slopes are covered by a dense forest of pine, oak, deodar and fir, which provide forest products like wood, fodder and fuel. Now see children, as the height decreases, the cultivation or crop taking processes become easier for us. So that is why here in this mountain slopes, because that is the middle part of the Himalayas, that is why mountain slopes are here. So it is easy. That is why the mountains are covered by the dense forest of pine, oak, deodar. These are the names of trees, children, which are very heighted and stand erect, straight. So the dense forest of pine, oak, deodar and fir, which provides the forest products also. Now what are the forest products, children? They provided us that wood, fodder and fuel. The hill slopes are used for practicing terrace farming. Now children, what is meant by terrace farming? You know, at our home also there is a terrace. Actually, here according to the mountain ranges, terrace means slope farming. As we know, these are the mountain ranges, that is where the slope is there. So, step by step terrace farming is there. See here in the picture also you can see. Terrace farming practiced in the Himalayas. This is the slope. Right? See here. Terrace farming means farming practiced on the slope that have been cut into steps. It is given. Terrace farming means it is also farming but which is practiced onto the slope and which is divided or which is cut into the different steps. That is called terrace farming. See, fruit orchards and tea plantation are present in this region. Therefore, unlike the greater Himalayas, the lesser Himalayas are well populated. See here children, most of the tea plantation. Is present in the hill stations only. Why the tea plantation is there in the hill station? Instead of this, we can see the tea plantation into Kuti, Kunnur, isn't it Darjeeling? Why it is like this? Because there are the slopes, and on that slopes, just like terrace farming, it is easy to take the products of tea. Yes, and because of this, all the reasons, unlike greater Himalayas, the lesser Himalayas are well populated. Yes, children, because temperature is low, we can take the plant, we can do the plantation over there. So that is why, which is suitable for the human beings. Got it? Till here everyone understood about greater Himalayas, then middle Himalayas. Okay? See here the value tip is given. The valley of flower in West Himalayas is famous for its numerous varieties of flowers. We must not pluck flowers and destroy the natural beauty. Yes, children, the valley of flower is the very famous tourist spot here. We can see variety of different types of flowers. But we have to protect them. We have to take care. See, here also in the picture, you can see a tea plantation in Sikkim. How they are doing the tea plantation. Terrace farming also and tea plantation also. Yes. Children, many popular valleys like valleys of Kulu, Kangra and Kashmir and hill stations like Mussoorie, Shimla, Nainital and Darjeeling are located in this region. Yes, children, these are the very famous tourist hill station, tourist spot. Most of the tourists, they are visiting in the summer season to these hill stations. So, we can see the terrace farming, tea plantation over this hill station, over this region. So everyone understood till here? Anyone have doubt? If you have any doubt, you can ask me by the mail. Yes. So the next part is outer Himalayas, or we can call it as a lower Himalayas or Shivalik. See here in this picture, you can see the outer Himalayas or lower Himalayas. Now children, the lower Himalayas is also known as the Shivaliks. The Shivaliks or the outer Himalayas is the southernmost and the lowest range of the Himalayas. We can call it as the bottom of the Himalaya. Shivalik is known for the presence of special scenic valleys called dunes. See here, now what is meant by dunes? See, Dune Valley in Uttarakhand, which is very special for the scenery. For example, Dehradun, Patti Dun, Kotri Dune and Pinjor Dune. These hills in this region are covered with the dense forest and inhabited by rich wildlife. Its slopes are used for cattle rearing and growing crops like rice, potato and maize. Now children, this is the bottom of the Himalayan mountain range. This is the outer Himalayas or lower Himalayas. That is why we can see the wildlife, dense forest. Yeah, because temperature is normal where you, a human being or living thing can easily survive. And as a result of this, we can see the inhabited human in forest and inhabited by the rich wildlife. We can see the different types of animals also. One more thing is here, that is the Shivalik Hills. It's said to be the storehouse of timber. Timber, it is the name of a tree. It is the name of a plant. So we can call it as a storehouse of timber. Why? Because in this Shivalik ranges, we can take the most of the product of timber. Now children, in North India, this range marks the end of mountains and beginning of plains. Yes, children, as we know, there are three parallel ranges of Himalayas. They are Greater Himalayas, Middle Himalayas or Outer Himalayas, Lower Himalayas. So, after Lower Himalayas, in the North India, the mountain ranges ends here. And then, it is the beginning of the plains. So, in between them lies Terai, which is the dense marshy land. What is it called? Terai. And Terai means it is the dense marshy land. It is the part of land also. So here crops like rice, wheat and sugarcane are mainly cultivated. So children, where we can see the Terai? Ending at the mountains and beginning of the plains. So whatever the middle part is there, that is known as Terai. Terai means a dense marshy land, and on that land we can take the crops like rice, sugarcane, wheat, etc. Have you cleared what is meant by Terai? Now children, our country India is blessed with this Himalayan mountain range. Why I am saying like this? Because it is the full protection for our country. This Himalayan mountain works as a guard for our country. So, about this Himalayas, we will see why it is the important for us. What is the importance of Himalayas for our country? See here. This is the exact location of the Himalayan mountain range, and there are the three parallel ranges of the Himalayas. They are the Greater Himalayas, Lesser Himalayas and the Shivaliks, or we can call it as a Lower Himalayas. Yes children, so what is the importance of Himalayas? See here. The Himalayas acted as a natural barrier against the foreign invaders in the past. Historically, it has prevented unfriendly arrivals and attacks from the other side of the mountain. So children, whatever is there, the other side of the Himalayan mountains, that are the enemies, they are continuously attacking on India. So in the, what we call ancient period, the Himalayan mountain ranges protected India from this unfriendly attacks, right? So just like a protecting wall, we can call it. Then the second point is, it forms a natural boundary between India and neighbors like China. Yes, Shiran, because of this Himalayan mountain, it is the, we can call it as a natural boundary also between the India and the neighboring country just like China. Then it protects our country from the cold winds of the north. As we know, the most of the northern part of India is covered with the snow and highest mountain ranges. So because of this snow, cold winds are there. So for that, the Himalayan mountain ranges, they protect our country from these cold winds. Again, it prevents the rain-bearing winds from leaving the country and this result is heavy rainfall in India. Yes, children, nowadays rain is very important for us, and because of this heavy rainfall we can take the crops, we can do the cultivation, terrace farming, all the things. Then the melting snow of the Himalayas gives rise to some of the major rivers like the Ganga and the Yamuna. Now children, do you know one thing about this? That is, most of the river they started from the Himalayan mountain ranges. Why it is like this? Because most of the glaciers are there only. Now what is meant by glacier? Glacier means it is the mass of ice or mass of snow, big mass of snow which is moving slowly. So what happened? Because of the hot sun, it melts slowly, and because of this melting it gives rise to the rivers. For example, Ganga and Yamuna, these rivers are called perennial rivers. Why perennial rivers? Perennial means, children, they have water throughout the year, isn't it? As they originated from the Himalayan mountain ranges, so they are water throughout, they have water throughout the year, and these are the major rivers from Himalayas. Next point is, many valuable products like timber, resin, medicines, etc. are obtained from the forest in this mountain ranges, isn't it? So we can call it Ayurvedic medicine, some like, so they are there from the Himalayan mountain ranges, many valuable products. After that, it also sustains a very rich variety of plants and animals which is not seen in other part of the world. The forests of the Himalayas are home to many animals such as yak, goat, snow leopards, musk deer and wild sheep. Yes, children, this type of wild animals we cannot see in any other part of the world. So because of this dense forest, this forest is a home for the such type of wild animals. We can see these wild animals in the Himalayan forest, Himalayan mountain ranges forest. So understood, these are the reasons. Because of this, the Himalaya is very important for our country India. It works like a protection wall. Now here, what is given in this cloud? See, there are thousands of glacier in the Himalayas. Glacier means, now you know, it is the slowly moving mass of ice or snow. It is just like an object which is made up of snow and it moves very slowly. So these are melting fast due to changes in the climatic condition. Nowadays global warming, you know, so because of this climatic condition, changing climatic condition, these glaciers are melting very fast. So how will this affect on us? What do you think? So just think this and discuss with your parents. Yes, children, now we will see the life in the Himalayas. So in a such a type of different climatic conditions, how the people, how the living things are survived in this area. So let's see here. Life in the Himalayas. Life is somewhat difficult in the mountains. Yes, because of the weather or climatic condition, because of the slopes are there for this. Many places still do not have proper roads and connectivity to the outside world, as it is the mountain ranges. So roads are just like U-pin turns, we can call it. So there is no proper roads and no connectivity from the outside world. Ship rearing is practiced by the people in this region. Isn't it? Do you know ships? That ship rearing is the practiced by these people in this region. Fruits and a few crops are grown as a means of livelihood. Different types of fruits and crops, they are grown here. Many people are part of the cottage industry, which includes wood carving, weaving of carpets, making woolen clothes, etc. Fruits like apple, orange, peach and plum are grown and sold here. During winters, people have to adjust to the harsh weather conditions. Yes, students. So these are the, this is the situation of the Himalaya. The people, they are living there, but they have to manage by this all the situation. For example, mainly there are the drastic changes in the climate, especially in the winter season. The weather is very harsh and people have to face it, adjust with this harsh condition. So they grow the fruits like apple, orange, peach and plum. They grown also there and they sold also. And with this fruit, the people, they are doing the wood carving, weaving of carpets, making woolen clothes, etc. So these are the, what we call it? These are the main occupation of the people, those who are living in this Himalayas. Main occupation we can call it. See here, you can see the carpet weaving in the Kashmir, how they are doing. It is in your textbook. Yes. Some of the Indian regions situated in the Himalayas are Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. These are the parts of India, these are the states of India, which is situated in the Himalayas. Yes, children. So today we saw about the northern mountains. In that we saw the whole information about Himalaya mountain ranges. The Himalayan mountain ranges are divided into three parallel ranges: Greater Himalayas, Middle Himalayas or Lower Himalayas or Outer Himalayas. And the other name for this is the Himadri, Himachal and Shivalik. Then the climatic conditions of these three parallel ranges, again the occupations, the cultivation, the crops growing, height, then highest peaks of the world, this thing, everything we saw in the Himalayan mountain ranges. Then we saw the importance of Himalayas for our country. And then the life in the Himalayas, how the people, they are living in such conditions. Okay, so today we saw this all about the Himalayan mountain ranges. In the next period, we'll continue with the northern plains. But before that, here is the homework for you. This is the activity which is given in your textbook, page number 24. Yes. So find out the reasons of the following. Yes, children, you have to find out. The Himalayan region is full of conical shaped trees like pine, spruce and fir. Conical means, you know, cone, ice cream cone or joker's cap. It is just like this. You have to hold the joker's cap or ice cream cone like this, then you can see the conical shaped trees. So why it is like this? Second is, mountaineers carry oxygen cylinder while climbing high mountains. Why they have to carry the oxygen cylinder while climbing the high mountains? And then third one is, Himalayan rivers are perennial in nature. Now children, perennial rivers means what? These rivers have water throughout the year. That is called perennial rivers. So why the rivers originating from the Himalayas, they are called as perennial rivers in nature? Okay, so you have to find out these three reasons that we will discuss in the next period. So in the next period, we are going to continue with the northern plains. Till here, everyone understood? Read the lesson properly, children. Meanings are also given over there. Try to understand the lesson. If you have any doubt, any queries, you can ask me by the mail. My mail ID is ivbct@pratibhaintschool.org. Understood? Yes, children. So today we are going to stop here. Stay home, stay safe, take care of yourself and your family. Bye-bye. Have a good day.